Welcome to another teardown video. Ooh, look at this one. Have you ever seen a more crazy sensitive meter? Ooh. So this is called a galvanometer. It is actually an ohm meter. But it can read really, really crazy milliohms. So we've got four different ranges. And what I see here is that, so let's try and see if we can show you. See? So this is the range between 0.2 and 2.1 ohm. Okay? When you change the ranges, it also changes the readout magnifier like that. And that is really, really cool. See if we go back to from 0.2 to 2.1 ohm. And then we dial this one all the way down to 0.2 ohms is 200 milliohms. All right. And then they said, say something about 2.1 ohms, that is 2100 milliohms. That is a pretty good resolution, isn't it? So there's a test button where you apply the voltage to the bridge. So this is actually a bridge where this is the known value in the bridge, and the unknown value you connect here in a 4-point configuration. So it's a 4-wire ohm meter, of course. And then you just adjust for zero and then read the value. So that is how it works. Mains input was broken, so it fell apart when I touched this meter. And how to open this thing? That is not so easy. There were some like 4 rubber feet, and you couldn't really figure out how to take these off. So I killed one in the in the experiment. And also there was this plate where you could only see one screw, and the other 2 screws, they were hidden inside the rubber feet. But with this one removed, and here is a full user guide how to use this product. And they're doing exactly what I said. You adjust for zero and then you read the value. And I find 2 secret screws in here. And that is, of course, for opening. So here's what I did. I take a 4-point test lead system. That's connected to the 4 points here, exactly as it's supposed to be, right? 2 on one side, and I'm really trying here to get a good connection and see what happens. So I took 1 ohm. So 1 ohm should be in the middle of this range, right? So that is 1,000 milliohms. And then I push the test button, and there's no indication. See, if I go to one side, it goes positive. And if I go negative to the other side, okay. It goes, there's something in it that works a little bit. It also goes super much bananas like this. Maybe it is the on-off switch, because this feels like it is. Sometimes it's 5 watts, 7 watts. Sometimes it's 0.0. So I guess half of it is in this problem. Because when I'm moving around here, maybe I... All those watts. This can't be the test watts. I will be blowing up stuff, right? Yeah, something is working and something is clearly not working. So, I think we need to tear it down. What is inside? All right, we are in. And this unit is really, really beautiful. So this is the mains input, and it goes to the test switch and back again to the transformer, and then rectifier diodes and some sort of a voltage regulator, I assume. So we got some capacitors and stuff, and a little tiny transistor down there. So maybe this is a part of the voltage regulation or current something for the source. And that will be all the different reference resistors in use for the different ranges. And look at... ooh. So this is the resistor. When you're turning this, the dial, there is a slider that goes on a thick piece of resistor wire. Of course, you can go all the way around. And look how they made this, the end. So this is a micro-ohm potentiometer. Isn't that just amazing? I haven't seen anything like this before. But if you're turning this up and down and you're having problems, maybe we have a problem with this connection. The way that the red wire is screwed to that end, that worries me a little bit, because this is micro-ohm thingy here, right? And when I'm looking at a design like this, I can't help thinking, how old is this? Anybody got a clue? Maybe we could consult the internet. Maybe we should try and Google a little bit, unless somebody is smarter and knows. Okay, so this is the same diode, that transistor. I don't know what the kind of the transistor that one is. Yeah. So this is what it consists of. Still haven't found the bug yet. I think I'll try and bypass the on-off switch and see if it's more stable for a start. That is a fairly simple mod to do. And then if the rest works, then okay, we can just replace the switch. It's also, the feeling here is a little dodgy. I really don't like that feeling, so maybe that explains the problem. But what do you know? Micro-ohms and stuff. Oh, yeah, I saw something that was really cool. Look at those handmade resistors with strings wound around and tied all up, tape and some labels, and actually also you find signatures. Well, let's see if I can get this. Let's see. They wrote SP. And here handwritten. See, and down here SN. So somebody is signing for those resistors being accurate. Wow. So how accurate is this thing? Really, really a lot. So it is still this 1 ohm resistor. And we're still in the 0.2 to 2.1 ohm range. And look at that. It is now nice and stable. Look at that. Yes, yes, yes. I fixed it. So if we dial it to zero, yes, yes, yes. Very close to 1 ohm. So I think this thing works now. and what I did. Let's turn it off. I fixed this screw. A little bit of cleaning and re-screwing this, because of course this is a super weak point. We got two different pieces of metal that's supposed to connect at like micro ohm resistance here. Will of course jam this meter completely, right? But okay, one more thing fixed, ready to be packed and assembled and traded for something else and funny. So if you want this, come and trade.